I was asked to speak about the challenges of reduced diameter implants, and having been involved in dental implantology now for, I hate to say it, almost 25 years, it's been interesting to observe the evolution in implant design. We've gone from surface technology, we've gone rough, and then we've gone back to micro rough from smooth. We've gone transmucosal, bone level, transmucosal, back to bone level. We've got implants with different thread designs. We've got parallel walled, tapered implants, all sorts of variations of different implant designs over the years. And at one point in time, in terms of implant diameter, we went wide or fat implants, and now we're coming back down to narrow implants as an area of interest. I think it's fair to say, though, that the general impetus for these design changes that we've seen over the last 20 to 30 years has been a direct result of the clinical imperatives or the clinical indications or the clinical limitations that confront us in implant dentistry. So with reduced diameter implants, clearly an example or two examples are here in front of you where you have reduced restorative spaces, small teeth. Small teeth require small implants because small implants can provide you with small restorative platforms, and then you can restore the teeth in a dimension and shape that's appropriate for that tooth replacement. That's the restorative side. From a surgical side, which of course is what I'm also possibly have a bias for and more interested in, is the fact that reduced diameter implants may have significant advantages in the clinical situation where we're confronted with reduced bone volume. And here I'm talking specifically about the orofacial or the buccolingual thickness of the bone once a tooth has been removed and the ridge has resorbed over a period of time. And the ability to use diameter-reduced implants has significant advantages because it might be able to, in many situations, avoid the need for a staged bone grafting procedure for the patient, reduce the patient's overall morbidity, and in fact expand the treatment and clinical options available to our patients.